Well, praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Praise the Lord, everybody. He woke us up this morning. He started us on our way this morning. We were able to press our way to God's house this morning. He breathed new breath into us this day. Let's give God some thanks and some praise for his goodness and his mercy towards us. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We welcome you that are in the sanctuary this morning. It is time for worship. It's time to praise God. It's time to let our burdens down at the foot of the cross and know that Jesus has taken it to the King for us. For those of you who are joining online, we are so grateful and thankful for your presence, and we ask that God would bless you immensely. So at this time, I ask that you will prepare your hearts and minds to worship our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Will you give a God hand a clap of praise this morning? Amen. And at this time, we turn it over to the Mass Choir for their opening selection.
Somebody give God some praise this morning. Come on, stand to your feet and help us praise the Lord. Come on, shout God some praise. Come on and shout God some praise in this building. This morning when I rose, yeah. This morning when I rose, yeah. This morning when I rose, yeah. I know the Lord
will take care of me.
I know the Lord
will provide for me.
And I know he will. This morning when I rose, yeah.
I didn't have
this morning when I rose, yeah.
I didn't have
this morning when I rose, yeah.
I didn't have
I know the Lord
will take care of me.
I know the Lord
will provide for me.
And I know he will. Listen, I woke up this morning to the bright sunshine. Woke up this morning to the bright sunshine. Woke up this morning to the bright sunshine. Well, I know the Lord. I know the Lord. And I know he will. Yeah, listen. Woke up this morning with the Holy Ghost. Woke up this morning with the Holy Ghost. Woke up this morning with the Holy Ghost. I felt like walking.
Walking.
Anybody feel like walking?
Walking
with the master. And then I felt like talking. Talking to the Lord. Felt like talking. Anybody feel like talking, y'all? Then I felt like singing. Felt like singing. I said I felt like singing. Anybody feel like singing, y'all? I felt like shouting. Felt like shouting. I felt like shouting. I felt like shouting. One more thing. Or one more thing. I got one more thing. One more thing. I felt like praying. I felt like praying. and our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. I felt like praying. I know the Lord
will take care of me.
I know the Lord
will provide for me.
I know the Lord
will take care of me.
I know the Lord
will provide for me.
And I know He will.
He ain't got me all the way.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord,
yeah. Hallelujah. Come on, give God glory. Bless the Lord.
How many of us felt like praying? Amen. If you prepare your hearts and minds with me to go to prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for allowing us to wake up this morning and feel like praying, feel like shouting. We woke up this morning with no doubt that you can do all things. The word tells us that you're a waymaker, a miracle worker, a promise keeper, and light in the darkness. Be the light in our darkness, God. No matter what that darkness looks like, no matter what it feels like, because it can look different for all of us. Be the light that we need when we're frustrated at work, when we're frustrated with our spouses, when we're frustrated with our children, God. Just be the light in our darkness and the things that we feel are darkness, God, that other people may not understand, but you understand that that darkness is something that you need to shine a light on. Your word says you're a way maker, God. Make a way for us this morning. Make a way for those that are still on their way to your house this morning, God. Make a way for us to be in a world, in the world, the way you want us to be in the world, dear God. Be the way that you want us to be around our peers, around our coworkers, in our community. Show us the way, God, that you want us to live, that you want us to be. God, at this time, I just ask that you be with those that are sick, those that are tired, those that are just feeling down on themselves. God, be with relationships, God, be with marriages, be with friends that are going through a hard time and just don't know which way to turn, God. Be with our children, dear God. Protect them wherever they go. Be with them in school. Protect their minds. God, we ask you this morning to be with the politicians, the people that are making decisions for the world. Be with them that they make decisions that are your way, God, that are glorifying to your will. Heavenly Father, just be with us this morning as we begin to worship in your name. The Holy Spirit is already here, but God, just be with us as we begin to magnify your name. Be with the pastor this morning as she brings us a word, a mighty word. Be with the band as they play your praises. Bring with the choir that they sing your praises. And be with all of us so that we may lift your name up to glorify you. In your precious name we pray. Amen.
Oh,
gave me the victory.
Thank you.
How many of you love Jesus this morning? How many of you love Jesus this morning? How many of you love Jesus this morning? How many of you know that God has been good to you? How many of you love Jesus this morning? That he didn't kill you in spite of you? How many of you love Jesus this morning for just wrapping his loving arms around you and keeping you in the midnight hour? How many of you love Jesus this morning? Because he's a healer. He's a promise keeper. He's a way maker. How many of you love Jesus this morning? How many of you really love him? If you really love him, say yes. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's really love the Lord. Hallelujah. You don't know what he's done. Make it personal because he gave you what? Do you really love him on today? Sing it from the depths of your souls. Do you really love him? We don't know your testimony, but you know. He gave it to you way back on Calvary. Do you really? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's give God a hand clap of praise on today. Let's give God a hand clap of praise on today. Hallelujah. 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 Sometimes we just gotta sit in it. We gotta sit in it. Because we don't know what folk have been through. We don't know what God has saved you from. We have no idea. That's between you and God. But every now and then, we got to give God thanks and praise. Every now and then, we got to decree and declare that we love him. That we love him because he first loved us. Yes. Hey. You may not understand why somebody is shouting. You may not understand, but they have gone through a lot to get here, to open up their mouth and just say, God, I worship you. God, I praise you. God, I'm so grateful for you. God, thank you for keeping me. Thank you for loving me. Thank you for being there when nobody else was there. Yes. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Will you pray with me one more time today? Will you pray with me one more time today? Gracious and eternal God. God, we are so grateful and thankful that you love us in spite of us. God, we are so grateful and thankful that when we turned our backs on you, you didn't turn your backs on us. God, we thank you on today for your love, your grace, and your mercy that you continue to breathe afresh on us. God, we love you. As the song plays, we are reminded that each and every time we decree and declare that we love you, we are just saying, God, we want to give ourselves away to you more and more, God, because, God, we understand that there is the divine connection. God, we understand that we want to be connected to your divine power, God. God, we understand that there's just something you are up to, and God, we just want to be a part of it. And so, Lord God, we thank you for breathing new life on us. God, we thank you for being a way maker and a promise keeper. And God, thank you for not forgetting about us, but writing our names in the book of life, God, because God, you know every hair on our head. You know every lie that we told. You know everything, every sin that we have committed, and yet you still love us. And so, God, we say thank you. We thank you for your grace and your mercy, those things, those twins that we did not deserve. But God, we're so grateful for them. So God, continue to breathe on us. Open up the windows of heaven and pour us out a blessing that we don't have enough room to receive. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, we pray. Let the people of God say amen and amen and amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's prepare our hearts and minds to hear the announcements.
Good morning, church. Morning. All right, just a few announcements for y'all this morning, then we can get back to it. All right, so one, as I look out, it's a lot of pink and purple, so I just want to say y'all look good, look real good. So we are wearing this pink and purple for Breast Cancer Awareness Month and also Domestic Violence Awareness Month. There are resources in the back for, you know, more information on both of these causes. So today, immediately after church, we have the Youth Game Day. So I'll say that again. Today, immediately after church, we have the Youth Game Day for ages 10 to 18, a time for some fun, a time for some fellowship. The contact person is going to be Ms. Marquand Lowe. Now, the ACAN has partnered with the Elks Club and is sponsoring a baby product giveaway this upcoming Saturday from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. We've been asked to spread the word, so if you know people who could use some supplies, tell them to come on down to the Elks Club. All right, and just a reminder, we'll be having All Saints Sunday service in November. This is where we will be remembering those of our congregation members who have passed away. And that date of passing would be from October 1st, 2022 to October 1st, 2023. We are asking members of Asbury Town Neck who have lost those family members to submit their names, a photo, their sunrise, and their sunset date. And send those in no later than October 25th. And please don't forget, we do have the upcoming Trunk or Treat event for the kids. There's an online sign-up sheet that just lists the ways in which you can contribute. So just hit the sheet, assign your name. If you have any questions, Ms. Marquand Lowe, our Youth Ministries Coordinator, can help you out. And of course, we know this, but I want to keep on saying it. On Wednesday morning, we gather together for our midweek prayer. E.W. Keaton says, prayer is the master key that opens all the doors to God. So we invite you to join us at 8 a.m. every Wednesday for a short devotional and prayer. The conference call number is in your weekly email and on our church website. Last but certainly not least, October is Pastor Appreciation Month, a time where Asbury, we can set aside some funds, some love, just to acknowledge our pastor for just the great work that she is doing. The Bible tells us to honor, respect, and love on those who labor for us. So pastor appreciation envelopes are available, and we are asking you to not make checks out to the church, but to the pastor directly. Let's all show her some love for the love that she shows us and the sacrifice that she puts into leading our flock. And that's it for the morning announcements. Thank you all.
Greetings, Asbury Town Neck family and friends. Welcome to the ATN Network. Luke chapter 6, verse 38 reads, "Give, and it will be given to you. A good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, will be poured into your lap. For with the measure you use it, it will be measured to you. Therefore know, God takes whatever we give and multiplies it, so that we can be blessed to be a blessing." Brothers and sisters, currently we have four ways to give. You can call 410-647-4000. 3461 to arrange an in-person drop-off. You can mail your tithes and your offerings to 429 Asbury Drive, Severna Park, Maryland, 21146. Or you can visit our website, asburytownnet.org, and click the donate button. Or you can use the Cash App at $ATNUMC. Thank you for your continual support of the ministries of Asbury Towneck United Methodist Church. We invite you to continue to join us for worship and the word.
All right, y'all, just one revision. The baby product pickup and drop off is actually going to be here at the church, not the Elks Club, but here. Let us prepare for offering. Father God, in this moment in time, Lord, we have the opportunity to give back, Father God. You have bestowed so much upon us, Father God, so we just take this moment with cheer, with glee, with happiness to provide back to you, Father God. We thank you for being there when we sow, Father God, so we can receive your blessings when we reap, Father. So we thank you so much, God, for you and this opportunity, Lord. It's in the precious name of Jesus we pray. Amen.
Please stand if you're able, for all things come of thee. Remain standing for the reading of the scripture.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Our scripture comes from Philippians 3:3-14. We rely on what Christ Jesus has done for us. We put no confidence in human effort. Though I could have confidence in my own effort, if anyone could, indeed, if others have reason for confidence in their own efforts, I have even more. I was circumcised when I was 8 days old. I am a pure-blooded citizen of Israel, and I am a member of the tribe of Benjamin, a real Hebrew if there ever was one. I was a member of the Pharisees who demand the strictest obedience to the Jewish law. I was so zealous that I harshly persecuted the church. And as far as righteousness, I obeyed the law without fault. I once thought these things were valuable, but now I consider them worthless because of what Christ has done. Yes, everything else is worthless when compared with the infinite value of knowing Christ Jesus, my Lord. For his sake, I have discarded everything else, counting it all as garbage, so that I could gain Christ and become one with him. I no longer count my own righteousness through obeying the law. Rather, I become righteous through faith in Christ. For God's way of making us right with himself depends on faith. I want to know Christ and experience the mighty power that raised him from the dead. I want to suffer with him, sharing in his death, so that one way or another, I will experience the resurrection from the dead. I don't mean to say that I have already achieved these things or that I have already reached perfection, but I press on to possess that perfection for which Christ Jesus first possessed for me. No, dear brothers and sisters, I have not achieved it, but I focus on this one thing. Forgetting the past and looking forward to what lies ahead, I press on to reach the end of the race and receive the heavenly prize for which God through Christ Jesus is calling us. Amen.
Everything's gonna be all right.
Clap your hands and let everybody know everything.
got one more thing. I got one more thing. Somebody here that's new to love the Lord, just say everything.
Everything will be alright.
Stand on your feet and give God some praise at everything. Turn my life around, everything.
Everything will be alright.
Hey, hey. And then he placed my feet out on solid ground, everything.
Everything will be
alright. Hey, hey, alright. Hey, hey, I know. It's gonna be,
it's gonna be all right.
All right.
It's gonna be,
it's gonna be all right.
All right.
It's gonna be,
it's gonna be all right.
All right.
It's gonna be,
it's gonna be all right.
All right.
It's gonna be,
it's gonna be
all right.
All right.
It's gonna be,
it's gonna be all right.
It's gonna be,
it's gonna be
all right.
All right.
It's gonna be,
it's gonna be all right.
Yeah.
All right.
It's gonna be,
it's gonna be
all right.
All right.
It's gonna be,
it's gonna be.
He picked me up,
right.
Turned me all around.
It's gonna be
he placed
right.
My feet
all right.
Out on solid ground. It's gonna be,
it's gonna be,
yeah. It's gonna be,
it's gonna be,
all right.
All right.
It's gonna be,
it's gonna be,
all right.
All right.
It's gonna be,
it's gonna be.
I know, I know, I know, I know. It's gonna be all right.
It's gonna be
all right.
All right.
All right.
All right.
It's gonna be,
it's gonna be all right.
All right.
All right.
It's gonna be,
it's gonna be all
the
right.
Lord is my light
right.
And my salvation.
It's gonna be
whom
right.
Shall I be?
All right.
Oh, yeah.
It's gonna be all
right.
All right.
It's gonna be,
it's gonna be all
right.
All right.
It's gonna be.
It's gonna be all right.
It's gonna be all right.
It's gonna be
all right. It's gonna be all right.
All
right. It's gonna be. All right.
It's gonna be.
I've got a feeling way down in my soul that everything. Yeah. If Jesus watched you, you want to let somebody know that it's going to be all right. No matter what you're going through, if you trust God, it's going to be all right. I know, I know, I know. I don't know about you, but I'm blessed this morning. I got up to see the bright sunshine just one more day. I want to thank him. I want to thank him every day. Because he's blessing me. He's blessing me. Yes, he is. But I know it's going to be all right. Hey, hey.
I just want to take a moment and have you prophesy to yourself. Just take a moment and tell yourself it's going to be all right. 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 And guess what? If you're not ready to believe it yet, they're going to keep singing it in their spirits and their souls until you do. Because sometimes we don't always come to church feeling all right. Sometimes we come to church being broken and being in places and spaces where we just need to be healed. Because I don't know about you, but my church is a hospital for the sick. It's a place where folk come to get well. So it's okay if you didn't come to church feeling all right. But the hope is that you will encounter the one who is the balm of Gilead, who's able to heal the sin-sick soul and put some salve on those wounds that you have that are bleeding open. It's going to be all right. It's going to be all right. Hallelujah. It's going to be all right. You know, I feel like I could stay there for the whole time. Will you pray with me this morning? Will you pray with me this morning? God, we know it's going to be all right. God, we're going to continue to believe it's going to be all right, even if it doesn't look all right. Even when our mind get a little cloudy and when self-doubt comes in, God, we continue to decree and declare it's going to be all right. Because we know that you have started a good work in us, we'll see it unto completion until the day of Christ Jesus. God, we know that what the enemy meant for bad, God, you have the ability to turn it for our good. And so, God, on today, we prophesy over ourselves that it is going to be all right. And God, we praise you in advance. We worship you in advance, oh God. God, we just lift high your name in advance so that we might testify to your glory, your grace, and your mercy. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. I want to go back to chapter 3. I just want to read verses 12 to 14 in the NIV translation, but I wanted us to read Paul's testimony in the earlier translation, what was the New Living Translation. So we're just going to read verses 12 to 14 in the New International Version of the text. All right, it says it like this. Not that I have already obtained all this or have already arrived at my goal, but I press on to take hold of that for which Christ Jesus took hold of me. We can pause right there. Christ Jesus took hold of me. Brothers and sisters, I do not consider myself yet to have taken hold of it, but one thing I do, forgetting what is behind and straining toward what is ahead, I press on toward the goal to win the prize which God has called me heavenward in Christ Jesus. So just keep that in mind as we go through our text this morning. So again, we are in Philippians chapter 3, verses 3 through 14. Amen. Amen. So in my doctoral work, I always talk about lament. And the reason I talk about lament is because I think it's important for the life of the church. I think it embodies who we are as the people of God. It talks about being the voice of pain and the voice of prayer, and it allows us to express exactly how we are feeling. I don't know about you, but some of us might have grown up with testimony service. I grew up with joys and concerns in church. Did anybody grow up hearing the testimony service or joys and concerns? Amen? Is it bring them back? We might have a service to bring them back. Amen? But it's important for that to happen because I don't know about you, but in the Black church tradition, there was a reason why we had testimony service. There was a reason why we had joys and concerns because most of us didn't necessarily know what mental health was all about back then. We didn't have a full grasp around therapy or medication or those sorts of things, but we knew if we got to the Lord's house, there was somebody that would wrap their loving arms around us. There was an old church mother that was going to tell us it's going to be all right. But we also had permission, y'all, to emote. We had permission to share our feelings without being condemned about it. We could say, today is just not a good day. We could talk about how our kids were going down the wrong way and how we're just asking for prayers and asking that God would just keep them while they're out there doing whatever they are doing out there. Then we could begin to testify and talk about, I don't feel good. I got cancer in my body, or my arthritis is acting up, or the diabetes is taking away my limbs, and I don't know what to do. And I don't know if somebody's going to help take care of my kids when I can't work anymore. We could come to God's house, y'all. We could come to God's house and begin to testify. We could begin to tell about our pain, but without a shadow of a doubt, somebody would begin to still praise God. Because somebody had a testimony about how God was a healer and how God was a miracle worker and how God kept the lights on, how God made sure the water stayed on, how God made sure that the tuition was paid. There was always somebody who had a testimony. So this morning, when we get to the text, we go and we encounter Paul, who is testifying. He is testifying to the church in Philippi. It's believed that he is on Roman house arrest when he's writing this letter. And every time that I come across Paul, I think about the book of Acts when it seems like he's always in trouble. But every time he gets in trouble, y'all, know what he begins to do? He begins to testify about the goodness of God. He begins to tell the story of what God had done for him and how God had broken some chains off his life, how God had delivered him, how he became saved through his faith in Christ Jesus. He had a way of testifying. And so when we get to this book of Philippians, he is still testifying as he is encouraging the church, because he is so thankful for these folk. He know these folk don't got a lot of money, but they were able to pull together an offering to bless him while he was yet in prison. Can we talk about it? Sometimes we have folk that are disenfranchised that we don't want to help. And yet, this church in Philippi, who did not have a lot of resources, was figuring out how to get it done. And so when we get to this, Paul decides he's going to start with his own testimony. As he begins to encourage the church in Philippi, he begins to tell his own testimony. He doesn't start with all the good stuff, y'all. He kind of just begins to tell them a little bit about his identity. He says, I was circumcised by the age of 8. Meaning that, guess what? I know that at the very beginning of my life, the covenant of God was already present. The presence of God was already there. He's acknowledging, so prior to Jesus, people got circumcised, men got circumcised in order to be a part of the family of God. But aren't you glad we have Jesus, y'all? Because we become part of the family of God through our faith in Jesus Christ alone. Can we go there this morning? So if you don't know that, you are saved through your faith in Christ Jesus. That means that as soon as you said that Jesus Christ died on the cross for you, while you were yet a sinner, while you weren't doing things the right way, while you were acting the fool, and yet you acknowledge that God was the Lord of your life, and you begin to shift things and turn things and make good choices and put God first. This is what we're talking about. So when we get to Philippians chapter 3, he talks about, this is how I became a part of the family of faith. I became a part of the family of faith very early in my life. It was 8 days old when I was circumcised. And guess what? I'm a pure blood citizen of Israel, a member of the tribe of Benjamin. He's letting them know that I am Jewish to the bone. Like, I am a part of the tribe, one of the 12 tribes of Israel. This is a part of my identity. I was a Hebrew, if there ever was one. I was a member of the Pharisees. Remember, these are the religious leaders of the day. These are the ones that are the rule keepers, y'all. These are the ones who want to do everything like so. Amen? And he's saying, look, I was that guy. I was the guy who didn't always understand that we were saved by the grace of God. I only understood how to live by the letter of the law. And I was doing it in such a way that I was so zealous that I persecuted the church.
In other words, I was so zealous. I was so caught up in who I thought I should be. I was so caught up in the ways that weren't necessarily what God was calling me to be and God was calling me to do that I was wrecking shop in other people's lives. Can we go there this morning? Can we talk about it just real quick? Sometimes when we are in the midst of our destruction, we begin to destroy other people because we don't have a relationship with God. Because the Holy Spirit isn't, we're not allowing the Spirit of God to work on us. So we are causing confusion wherever we go. Can we go there this morning? So when we get in alignment with God, when our life is on the line and we choose to get in alignment with God, then we begin to see our relationships get cleaned up. And we also begin to see some folk fall off. Amen, Jesus. Because we become zealous for the right thing and not for the wrong thing. Can we go there this morning? This is what I'm feeling the Lord tell me to go. So. And then he begins to testify, and he kind of just wants to set the scene and let folk know, I didn't have it all together before this, y'all. Before I met Christ, I was a little all over the place, y'all. I wasn't necessarily the nicest guy out there, y'all. I wasn't necessarily kind to those who came in contact with me who believed differently than I did, and so I persecuted them. I put them on trial, and yet now it is me who is put on trial. It's now me that is under prison, under somebody else's sentence. It's now me who is suffering for the sake of Christ, and now I want to testify. Now I want to testify. I want to testify. Guess what? I'm not perfect, but each and every day I press on to possess the perfection which Christ Jesus first possessed me. Let me make it plain. I press on each and every day that God would continue to take hold of me. I don't know about you, but I know that I want God to take hold of me. Do you want God to take hold of you this morning? Because we can say, I love you, Lord, I truly love you. But if we're not allowing God to take hold of us, do we really love him? Because we're continuing to say, I want to do things like I want to do them. But if we're saying, God, possess me, God, take hold of me, then we have no choice but to be transformed by the power of a loving and righteous God. God wants to take hold of you this morning. Do you know that? Do you know that God wants an intimate relationship with you? Do you know that God wants you? He doesn't care if you are perfect. He doesn't care if you have sinned. He doesn't care if you lied yesterday. He doesn't care if you cheated. He doesn't care about any of that. He just wants you. Do you know that he loves you in spite of you? Because guess what? Paul had the right pedigree, y'all. He's a Pharisee of Pharisees. He a Hebrew of Hebrews. And yet he still was outside of what God was asking of him to do. And yet when he heard God's voice, when he heard the voice of God, he turned. Because that's what happens when God possesses you. That's what happens when God takes a hold of you, Brother Moon. There's some things that, do you know that's what repent means? It means to turn away. And I always say this, if you got to turn away from something, that means you turn into something. So we're turning away from sin, we're turning away from doubt, we're turning away from those things that no longer serve us, then we need to be turning towards the cross. He tells us, guess what? I don't think I got it all together just yet. Because to be honest, when I first started reading the text, he sounded a little arrogant to me. He started, you know, testifying, I was this big man, and I had all of this and all of that. And then he gets to this. He said, I don't mean to say that I have already achieved these things or that I have already reached perfection. There's this moment where we understand that Paul knows he himself is broken. He understands that I don't have it all together. I might be a teacher of the law. I might have testified. I might have been beaten, and I may have been thrown in jail. I may have been shipwrecked. I may have gone through all of these things. But I know God is still working on me. And that's part of my testimony, too, that God is still doing a work in me. Don't you know that God is still doing a work in you? God is still doing a work in you. We don't have to have it all together, but we have to continue to press toward the mark of the high calling that's in Christ Jesus. Because he's saying, I take hold of that for which Christ Jesus took hold of me. I do not consider myself yet to have taken hold of it, but one thing I do, forgetting what is behind and straining forward to what is ahead. Are you willing to press toward what's ahead of you and not allow what's behind you to continue to keep you captive? Because God is asking, do we want a deeper and more intimate relationship with him? Are we willing to press forward? Are we willing to press ahead? Are we willing to be in relationship with one that loves us so intimately and so wonderfully and so beautifully and so openly that he wants us to be better than ever? He wants us to have that testimony that it's going to be all right. God is inviting us to continue to press toward the goal to win the prize for which God has called us heavenward in Christ Jesus. That prize that we're talking about is eternal life. The prize that we're talking about is salvation. The prize that we're talking about is eternal relationship with the one who has saved us, who has delivered us, who has signed our names in the book of life when we said yes to God. This moment when we begin to testify, we are testifying that guess what? I don't got it right, but there is one who's always been righteous. There is one who's always believed in me when I did not believe in myself. There was always one who loved me when I didn't love me. There was always one who sought after me when I was lost. There was always one who breathed new life in me when I had no life to give. There was always one who saw about me when I was alone, deep in my sin, far from the peaceful shore, deeply stained within, seeking to rise no more. But the master of the sea heard my despairing cry, and from the water he lifted me, and now safe am I. Because I don't know about you, but the old folks used to tell me love lifted me when nothing else could help. Love lifted me when nobody else could come. Love lifted me. Brothers and sisters, I don't know where you are today in your faith walk. But I believe that God has called us to testify to his goodness and his mercy towards us. I don't know where you are with what's going on in your life, but there is a God who continues to testify that you are his and that he is yours. And if you just reach out and touch him, if you just call on his name, if you begin to call on the name of Jesus, if you believe in God on today, that Jesus saves it, Jesus delivers it, Jesus says, free, then you can begin to testify that I may not be where I want to be today, but I continue to press toward the mark of the high calling that's in Christ Jesus, because I know that God is not done with me yet. I know that God still has a purpose to fulfill in me. I know that God is working some stuff out for my good. I know that God is washing me clean. I know that God is doing a new thing in me. I know that God Brothers and sisters, we got to begin to testify like Paul and say, look, God, I don't got it together, but God, I continue to press toward the mark. God, I continue to press towards you, because the day you took hold of me is the day that I was set free. The day you took hold of me is the day that I was saved. The day you took hold of me, the chains begin to fall off. The day you took hold of me, I will never be the same again. So on this day, I pray that you'll testify to the goodness and the glory, the grace and the mercy of Lord God, our Savior. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, we pray, let the people of God say amen, amen, and amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If there's one in this place who does not know God as your Savior, if there is one in this place who does not know that Jesus is for you, if there's one in this place who are just asking God to breathe new life onto you, the altar is open. Would you come? Would you come today? If you were going left and it's time for you to go right, and you would like to rededicate your life to Jesus, maybe you have this testimony like Paul that, God, I don't got it together, but God, I am still pressing forward. The altar is open. Would you come? Hallelujah. Amen. At this time, will everyone stand around the building? Will you stand? Hallelujah. And as we stand, we are just standing, just saying thank you, God. So I want to invite you to raise one hand or two hands unto God. We're just going to do our benediction here, but as I do the benediction, I'm going to go ahead and just begin to pray for us. Actually, I'm asking Natasha to pray for us. Come on, Tasha. As she prays, I want you to know that as our hands are lifted high, this is a position of surrender. When our hands are open, we're open to receive the blessings of God. When our hands are closed, we can't receive anything. But when our hands are open, we're able to give up those things that don't serve us. When we're able to just say, God, in my imperfection, you are made perfect. And so as we open up our hands, oh God, we're just going to offer you a word of prayer.
Oh, Father, we stand before you so humbled and so grateful. We're so thankful for your Spirit. We're so thankful for all that you've done for us, all that you're doing for us, and all that you will do, Lord God. We are thankful to be covered in your blood and washed new, Father God. We are thankful that you go with us everywhere we go, Lord God. We are thankful for the transformation that you are doing in us, a work that you are doing in us that you are faithful to finish, oh Father. We thank you. We thank you for the service. We thank you for the opportunity to be able to gather in your name, Lord God, and give your name glory, Lord God. We thank you for the opportunity we have and the ability to just go out into this world and continue to shine the light that you put in us, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God. We love you. And we're so grateful to be chosen by you. In your precious name we pray. Amen.
May we continue to press toward the mark of the high calling that's in Christ Jesus. And may God take a hold of you. And may you testify that he has his hands on you. And that everything is what going to be all right. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we pray. Let the people of God say amen, amen, amen. We love you, family. There's nothing you can do about it. Go and make today a great one.
Oh God, I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. Give myself away, so you, here I am, here I am, here I stand. Lord, my life is in your Lord, I'm longing to see your desires revealed in me. I give myself away. Oh God, I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. I belong to you. Give myself away so you can use me. Give myself away. I belong to you. I give myself away so you can use me. Give myself away. Oh God, give myself away.
Hallelujah. Somebody bless the Lord.
We fall down, but we get up. We fall down, but we get up. Oh, yes. For a saint is just a sinner who